Namaste, welcome to Gita's Kitchen. Today we will make rice rava upma. This is something which many of you have asked for, and it can be made both for breakfast or also as a simple dinner recipe. So for that we require this broken rice or rice rava. I have already uploaded the video on how to make the rice rava at home. I'll give you the link in the description box. So I've taken 1 cup of this rice rava, and I have taken here 2 tablespoons of this tuvar dal, that is pigeon pea lentils. This also I have just run in the pulse mode in my blender jar and broken it coarsely and kept ready. Now let's start making. We are going to make it in the pressure pan itself so that it is faster here, and it tastes good when made with coconut oil. So today I am using coconut oil. I am taking 2 tablespoons of coconut oil. Earlier this used to be made traditionally in a bronze pan known as a vengala pane, and it would be cooked over a slow flame for nearly 25-30 minutes. But today we are making it in a faster, simpler way in the pressure pan. When the oil is hot, I am adding in 1/2 teaspoon of mustard seeds, 1/2 teaspoon of urad dal, a few cumin seeds. These are 4 dry red chilies. A few curry leaves, a little bit of hing. Also, just take less than 1/4 teaspoon. See, just about 5 or 6 black peppers, and coarsely pounded. Don't make it fine, then the color of the upma will get spoiled. Just a few of these you add. Next, we have to add in the water. For 1 cup of rice rava, I have taken 2.5 cups of water. Add in the salt. Here I have some freshly grated coconut. You can add about 1/2 cup of that and allow everything to come to a boil. The water is beginning to boil now. First I'll add in this broken dal to it. While adding with one hand, keep stirring with the other hand so that no lumps are formed. Then add in this rice rava also. Cover it, put on the weight, reduce the flame to absolute low flame and switch it off after about 5 or 6 minutes. I had switched it off after 6 minutes. We have waited for the pressure to die down. Yeah. Now we can remove it. Upma is done and ready. We just have to mix it all very well together like this. See, we have mixed the upma very well. Lovely, soft, fluffy upma, steaming hot. I'll just transfer it to my serving dish. So our rice rava or arisi upma is ready to be served. Today I have just served it with some jaggery powder. Actually, you don't need any side dish at all for this. This can be eaten as such. Some people like to eat it with some sugar or jaggery powder. Or even you can serve it with sambar or brinjal gochu. Personally, I like to have it with more kolambu. I feel the combination is very good. And if you want to serve it as a lunchbox recipe, you can just make it. But omit the coconut because it might get spoiled by lunchtime. Then you can use it as a lunchbox recipe too, or as a simple dinner recipe once you come back home from work. There are so many ways you can enjoy this. Now a small tip. Many of you might not have idli rava readily available at home. That is rice rava you may not have. But you want to make the rice rava upma. So what do? Just take 1 cup of raw rice, wash it, soak it in water for 10 minutes. Drain out the water and spread the rice on a clean white cloth for about 15 minutes to dry. That is, when you take the rice in your hands after drying, nothing should stick to your hand. It should be that much dry. Then put it in your blender jar and using the pulse mode, just pulse it 2 or 3 times till the rice gets broken to a coarse rava consistency. And then proceed with the rest of the recipe as it is. That way also you can enjoy an instant rice rava upma even if you don't have this. So do try out the recipe, share it with your family and friends, and come back to Gita's Kitchen for more such easy, tasty, traditional recipes.